Allahu Akbar. 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر ولله الحمد. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صلِّ وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد. عيدكم مبارك. عيدكم سعيد. الحمد لله. تقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us our righteous deeds over the past 10 days بفضل الله تعالى. By Allah's grace. قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. Say, in the grace of Allah and in the mercy and compassion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that rejoice. Find your joy. Find your happiness in God's grace. Find your happiness in God's mercy. Find your happiness in God's forgiveness. Find your happiness in God's compassion. Yesterday, brothers and sisters, the volume of Muslims who had their necks saved from Jahannam is unparalleled. We don't know how many millions of Muslimin yesterday achieved their life goal of being saved from Jahannam. Can you imagine that? How many? Because Prophet ﷺ tells us there is no day where more people are saved from Jahannam than the day of Arafah. Ask yourself, how many sins, perhaps in the billions of sins, were forgiven yesterday by the grace and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ask yourself how much dua, all of the supplications that we made, our brothers and sisters on the plains of Arafah, hear us Muslimin across the world pleading with Allah, begging of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how many billion of ad'iyah were accepted yesterday? These are things that we should say, Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Say Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Say Allah is the greatest and He is deserving of all praise, because this is the identity of a servant of Allah. The identity of a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who rejoices and finds his or her pleasure in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask yourself, young and old today, ask yourself, what exactly are we celebrating? What is the purpose of hundreds and hundreds of Muslimin, thousands across New Jersey, millions across the country, a billion plus across the world, all clamoring to come to the prayer space to do what? To celebrate what exactly? Are we here just to celebrate celebration? You look at how people join in joyous occasions throughout the year. People join just for the sake of having fun. It's just fun for this fun's sake. But in Islam, the reason for our celebration, the reason for our Eid, is far more profound. There's a fundamental purpose that governs the purpose, the cause of our joy. Who today does not experience happiness? We just, subhanAllah, spent 9 days trying to maximize our good deeds. Yesterday was a day of fast, a day of forgiveness, a day of pleading with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we come to the masjid to pray, to celebrate the Eid of Adha. Eid al Adha, the celebration of sacrifice. That is what we're celebrating. We're celebrating one of the most fundamental principles in our Islamic lexicon, which is at-tadhiyah, sacrificing everything that we have for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a very profound concept, by the way. When people just celebrate for pure enjoyment, senseless joy, just let's put on a party just to have fun. Muslims come and they change the entire paradigm. That's not why you should have fun. Indulgence for the sake of indulgence will never nourish you. But when you come for Salatul Eid and you celebrate with the Muslimin, you pray, you read Quran, you do dhikr, you do takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, that is where the Muslim finds their true joy, because this joy is unparalleled in its quality. When you rejoice for a deeper purpose, a purpose that is rooted in the divine reality, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then that joy will be everlasting. It will be a joy that lasts for you in this life, and a joy that you will find the beauty of it in the afterlife. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala governs us and directs our attention to this type of celebration. And so today we're celebrating sacrifice. We're celebrating the life of our father Ibrahim. When he was the embodiment, he is the father of prophecy, and he is the embodiment of what it means to sacrifice in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he was given that ibtila, that test, to slaughter his son. Imagine that. Think about that today. We come together as families. We love to see our children dressed up, happy, full of joy, giving them gifts. We are excited to give them their gifts and see them open their gifts. Imagine being tested and tried to do such a thing to your child. What a painful reality. But what did Sayyidina Ibrahim say? He went to his son and he said, you know, I have seen in my vision, in my dreams, أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ, that I am to sacrifice you. فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. You tell me, O son. You tell me, O son, what do you see? He said, يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. Oh, my beloved father, ya abati. Ya abati in the Arabic language is a term of endearment. Oh, my beloved father, you do what you are commanded to do. Allahu Akbar. What a powerful relationship between a father and a son who are fully committed to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fully committed to attaining the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Falamma aslama. And when they both surrendered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa tallahu lil jabin, and he placed his head down to slaughter. Imagine that. That whole occurrence happened while Sayyiduna Ibrahim's hand is on the head of Sayyiduna Ismail. A very, very powerful test that, by the way, no other human being after Sayyiduna Ibrahim will ever be tried with. No prophet of Allah after Sayyiduna Ibrahim or before him was ever tried with the same test in terms of the sacrifice that was expected of him. But he surrendered and he submitted. Why? Because of the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his son Ismail never looked at his father for one second in any way other than in an endearing fashion. Oh my beloved father, you fulfill your commands that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has obligated upon you. Subhanallah. Imagine, brothers and sisters, if our lives, if our day-to-day realities were mirrored in that same way. Imagine if every single day you and I, young and old, father, son, mother, daughter, all of us, our fundamental concern is, what is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is the most pleasing thing for us to do as a family? How should we dress? How should we talk? How should we earn our money? How should we gather? What should be our concerns? Should we pray together all five prayers in the day? Should we pray in jama'ah? Should we go to the masjid? Should we attend programs? Should we attend the khutbah? Should we make dhikr together as a family? Say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Say, La ilaha illallah. What is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because when Sayyiduna Ibrahim took our mother Hajar and Sayyiduna Ismail to the barren lands, and he was commanded once again by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave his most beloved wife, that finally his wife that was able to bear a child, and they bore that child. And Sayyiduna Ibrahim was told to leave them in the barren land. What a devastating thing that a man would have to experience, to have to leave his most beloved wife and his son. And his wife looked at him because she did not know what was happening. And she could see that he was distressed and he was tired. And she said to him, Allahu amaraka bihada. Is this a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And so he nodded his head to her. She said, Idan lan yudayyana Allahu abada. Then you go, don't worry. Allah will never ever forsake us. Allah will never let us be at a loss. Allah will never lead us astray. Look at the trust. Look at the confidence. Look at the love. And look at the willingness to sacrifice everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, this is the spirit that we are celebrating today. This is what we as a community need to aspire towards. Because we live in a time where sacrificing for the sake of Allah is not our first order of business. People are very disinterested in Allah's rights. People do not care what Allah thinks. People do not care about what Allah wants. And let me tell you, Allah does have very distinct expectations of how we should be. Allah has governs our thoughts. Allah has opinions and distinction. He has commands around our behaviors, and He has opinions and commands around our feelings and our spirituality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects from us, both inwardly and outwardly, to dispose ourselves in a way that is pleasing to Him. And so today, the day of Nahr, today is called the day of Nahr, the day of sacrifice. Today is a day where you commit yourself to disposing yourself in the manner that is pleasing to Allah, to be committed to sacrificing all of your personal interests and your personal desires and your personal indulgences and societal pressures, political concerns, whatever it is, you're willing to sacrifice everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was threatened and challenged in every possible way. They tried to assassinate him, they tried to harm him, they killed his followers, and then they tried to indulge him, and they tried to shower him with gifts. Why don't you be our king? How about we follow your religion one day and our religion one day? And he said to them, Wallahi, if you were to place the sun in my right and the moon in my left, I will never leave this affair. I will never leave the path of al-Islam. Brothers and sisters, ask yourself, what is the nature of your commitment to this religion? This is what we are celebrating today, by the way. Wallahi al-Azim. This depth, is what we are actually rejoicing. This is why we all got dressed up. This is why I wore my good hat. For this day. Wallahi al-azim. The hat that I inherited from my teachers. I wore it for today to celebrate this principle. So that when we stand together on the day of judgment, we can say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, we truly were a community that strive every single day to attain your pleasure. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he speaks about the days of Eid al Adha and the days of Tashriq, he says these are days of aklin wa shurbin wa dhikrillah. These are days of eating and drinking halal substances. Just, you know, because you gotta be careful here. And remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are days of rejoicement. For the next today and the next 3 days after, you enjoy yourselves. You have a lot of fun. But embedded within that is the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know what the distinct remembrance of the coming days is? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You are going to aggrandize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your hearts and minds. So after every salah, for the next 3 days, after every salah, you sit down with your children and your family. You said, even if you're praying alone, and you do the takbirat that you heard Shaykh Fouad doing in the beginning of today's salah. Say those takbirat. Make sure that you never miss the mark on the purpose of our existence here. Brothers and sisters, I understand the pressures are so grave and intense. It is a lot of work. But the beauty of our deen is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us so many pious predecessors and examples of people who really did sacrifice everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because there is no other reason to live. There is no other purpose that is identifiable that you can say, let me do this and not follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's path. Nothing. There's nothing that parallels. I don't care what you think your career is. I don't care about how much money you think you can earn. I don't care about the notoriety. I don't care about the political recognition or the social viability. None of those factors will ever compare and be parallel to the reality of being categorized as a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The most honorific, the most blessed, and the most praiseworthy station that any one of us sitting here today can achieve is that we are considered servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to be loyal servants. Wa Ibrahim ladhi awfa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he speaks about Sayyidina Ibrahim as my loyal servant. May Allah help us to be loyal servants on this day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us and help us to be truly servants that are willing to sacrifice everything for the sake of Allah. May we all commit ourselves today to sacrificing the sins that we're committed to. Brothers and sisters, ask yourself, if there's haram that you're engaged in, if you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, or you consume substances that are haram, you're addicted to things on the internet and watching things that are inappropriate, you do things that you know are categorically haram, challenge yourself today to say, I will leave everything that is displeasing to Allah simply for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know it's hard. Young people, I know how hard it is to sacrifice your feelings and your wants and your desires. And I know all of the young people sitting here, they have a tempest in a teapot kind of reality. They're bubbling from within. They want, because it's a very indulgent reality around us. Hyper-sexualized, hyper-indulgent. But you are strong believers, don't forget that. You are very capable believers. You're following as young people in the footsteps of Sayyiduna Ismail. When his father said, I am commanded to slaughter you, he said, Ya abati fa'al ma tu'mar, O father. And he was a ghulam, by the way. He was a young boy. He didn't even reach the age of 10 when he told his father that. Imagine. That is a plausible reality for all of us, to be true servants with that color and that type. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us servants like Sayyiduna Ismail, who have the confidence and the strength and the willpower to say no. To say, I will prefer the pleasure of Allah over my own indulgences and pleasures. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولك. الله أكبر 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 كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله brothers and sisters, Eidukum Mubarak, Eidukum Sa'id. I really, truly hope and pray that these are blessed and joyous days for you all, for us all, Ya Rab. May Allah bless our families. May Allah bless our children. May Allah bless and honor our parents. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our relationships. Brothers and sisters, today is a day of mahabba. It's a day of love. And love necessitates forgiveness. Forgive one another. Forgive that family member that you haven't been willing to forgive for the past 30 years. Call your brother. Call your sister. Call your aunts, your uncles, your grandparents, your parents. Call your children. Call your siblings. Call your cousins. Call your family members. Call your community. Send messages of love, even if you haven't called them in 10, 20, 30 years. No matter how awkward it is to reach out today, reach out for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Overcome your awkwardness. Go find that community member that you've been tussling and toiling with, that you've been bickering with, and hug them, and love them, and tell them how much you care about them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because by the way, all this stuff that we hold on to, all this nonsense that we hold on to, it will be nothing, it will be meaningless once we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all alone. And so let us have the foresight and the willpower to do the things that are pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah loves to see people coming together. Allah loves to see His servants joining together. Saffan wahid, one body, one row, one group, one interconnected unit. So may Allah always make this masjid full of believers, together serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, commit yourself to the house of Allah. Commit yourself to this masjid. Be present, pray, serve, donate, support, help as much as you can. Because our masajid do not belong to us. They belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are caretakers of these masajid. So I pray that a part of your commitment today is a commitment to the house of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us all. Barakallahu feekum wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala sayyidina Muhammad wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Now you can go have breakfast. Yeah.